Oh, hello everyone, welcome back to Satisfactory episode, 37. I thought you have to do a little bit of voiceover on this episode, except for the last part at the end. Normally Windows is switching its audio back to the right position, to the right microphone. I have switched to my VR, it's switching my audio around. At this time, I didn't notice it did not switch the right microphone back, so... Yeah, I have to do a voiceover on this to do this. So, yeah, you're just seeing me quickly how I'm building the foundations really fast. Walking on the edge, doing all this. So, I can do it really, really fast this way. I just now noticed that one pillar is off. I just see that now, really. But yeah. Yeah, I'm placing all the pillars out, so I'm doing this all. So, here we are then at the refineries again. Of course, you've been looking around while I was explaining stuff, but it was not getting recorded. See, I don't know exactly what I was working on. I think it's still plastic. No, it's the start of the plastic, even. You see that all the old processing is done. Here I'm figuring out that I think I could basically do. Crossover basically for the refine, so I don't have to do the belt all the way around. I can basically I can cross it over. It makes a lot of less work, and on the other end also more work, but I have to figure out the distance, of course, get it perfectly done there, but still as tight as possible. So a lot of work bringing out on how to do this. Plastic is in total is going to be 65 refineries for plastic. The whole processing itself is already 60 refineries. So that's a lot of whole arcane process there. I think it was about 3,600, if I'm not mistaken, that we can process. That's a good amount. That's a good amount. It's not even half of what's on the map anyway, but. It's all just under the half with good maximum capacity of pipes and what we can pull out of an drill well. So here I'm probably calculating out what we need. We need also, of course, water. Because poly we cannot just straight away turn into plastic. We need also water with it. That's going to need even more pipes for that. And 130 per minute is basically needs 60 per minute, so one belt per refinery is split up into two refineries across here, so I have a leftover of 10 plus 10 the additional refineries that have not been used. There's not 130 left over that. So I need to measure out everything exactly to fit it out. But 60 per minute for that, and there's 130 from the other side coming in. Oh, that's another thing. There's 130 per minute, 60 on that one, and then 60 on that one's 120. have 10 left over. So basically after 6 refineries I can have 1 additional refinery on the poly that's left over. Yeah, all that stuff that I built there already, that of course I can take down again. And take him with me with the train. That's the fix still from them, that the train is bouncing towards this track and I got taken with it when I just jumped over it. Of course I'm thinking I might need to move the station for loading the plastic up. That's something that we'll figure out a little bit later, see how it's fixed. Fit it, but by the looks of it, it will fit fine. I can just keep the station there. We just need to probably just build a balancer because we're not gonna run everything at once. At least not all the refineries, because I have way not enough power for that. It is 20 per minute, so I think it's like 20 with the Mark IV belt was. 24 refineries that can fit on one Mark IV belt. Because we're still way off the Mark V's. And I'm probably never gonna change it anyway to Mark V's here, because when it runs, everything is sorted out. And we'll get there perfectly, so. And of course, I don't know how far I can build that to the back still. But there is a limit somewhere. But it seems to be on an angle. And of course, we need still water. So I'm thinking about putting water pumps somewhere around here. And the pipes run alongside the track. Now I'm thinking of, this might be not the best idea because depending on later on when the updates, when trains get collisions, might need to double up the track, so we don't now we're like a single track, and then we might go a double track so trains can move easier. But we'll see if that's gonna need it or not. Then again, I do have the room there to. I don't have the room even there to do double track. Yeah, foundation missing there. Till up today, still hasn't been replaced. If I would do a double track here, it would fit. Just. The other side won't fit. But then I need to move the whole station, really. Yeah, yeah, I need to. Just looking a little bit on how much space I need. What's the next? 60, no, that's 98 refineries even. One was running 50% then for all the rubber. That's gonna be the 98 refineries in total for the rubber to handle the polyresin form. 30 refineries that process in the oil. I don't know exactly how much space I need there. And of course, I want to use as less space here in the middle. For the outputs. Well, yeah, it's 480. Like I said, 480 on the Mark IV, that's 24 refineries. 24, if you have 10, it will be 240, but it's 20 output is 480. So. We have of course some plastic, no fluid output. It's only plastic output. It's really weird to do this voiceover because I'm just looking at myself, looking at stuff. All I was recording was, of course, talking. Eh? Yeah. Looks a bit weird. And here we are a few hours further figuring out how to fit stuff. I can see that I built a small piece over here, connecting up to the refineries. You can see that I was measuring everything exactly out so it fits perfectly. Don't have additional conveyors over there, so the conveyor lift exactly fits all the splitters. You can show they connect up perfectly. That there are Mark 1 lifts, conveyor lifts, and that one doesn't connect up for some reason. I was trying to figure out why it was not connecting up. Some reason it's just the distance is off. Well, the other ones were fine. I had no clue what was happening. Even that one doesn't connect up, and the last one doesn't connect up either. So I was like really weird for what is happening here, why it doesn't connect up. I used the control button for place the refineries all in line, and for some reason they are not in line. I have just no clue what it was. Eventually I did figure out what it was. If you aim at the ground and use control, after 3 or 4 refineries, the refinery moved back very, very slightly. So the way you have to place the refinery is basically really like, you have to connect them up while looking at the refinery on the sides. And here I'm explaining how I'm lining up everything perfectly. Over here you can see I placed the belt. I'm looking at the yellow lines on the refinery, the output. Trying to get that in the middle, the blue line. Then aiming at here, trying to get the two arrows from both sides lined up perfectly in the middle. And then the splitter was perfectly placed in the middle, but still have this issue that they don't connect up here. It looked like perfectly, but then not for some reason. But like I explained, they moved up slightly, but by the way how I was placing them, so it's a bit weird. So you really have to be specific how you place stuff. I've tested out with later on with smelters even. I didn't run into the issue there. It seems to be only with the big structures that is happening. That is happening with it. And you can see that this one of the findings is left over then, that goes on a separate belt. Yeah, and then after the... So the first refinery was used, second refinery is not used, gets on a belt. Here you can see I'm explaining a bit... I was explaining without getting recorded how this was not... fitting. So here we are back. By the looks of it, I have them now. Managed to connect them up. Here I'm gonna show you what is happening. Look at the red lines from the refineries. Here they are perfectly lined up. Here you can see that's slightly moved over, very, very little bit. And that's the way you build them when you aim at the ground and then use control to place them. you aim at the refinery that's already placed, then you're not gonna have this issue. Then the refinery won't move over. You can see here, like, with the dots on the foundation, the difference how far they move over. And imagine then, when you place 30 refineries in a row, how far that's gonna move over. I've tested it out even, and basically, you see here, so we're placing that it's not in line. Doesn't get in line. You can believe that after 15 refineries already, refinery moves so far backwards that it can move completely one step forward, basically. That's how far they move over then. So the only way basically to place it is do not aim at the floor. Walk a little bit further away and aim at the refinery itself. And then use control. It won't move over. Then they stay perfectly in line. I don't even know with the old refiners if that's the same case for me, but that's all connected up now. That's all fine, so I'm not gonna change anything on that there either. Just gonna leave that how it is. I should hear also the last bit of the recording. I do have a voice. I figured out that the microphone was not working, so I should shortly be back with my own voice while I was recording the video. Alright then, well, we got a little bit further. There are like enemies nearby, I don't know where they are. This whole thing is literally set up here. This whole thing, that's not true. It's almost half of the plastic production that's been set up now. Only half of it, about it. What we do need to go do now, definitely in the next episode, is I have to get the other splitters, the smart splitters. I really need to have those now, because this one will be fine. 130 comes out there, Mark 1 belt should be going like 65 goes in there, but it's only a maximum of 60 can go in there. That's what it can handle anyway. So it require 60 anyway per minute. That's not a problem. But then on this one, we still have 70 left. Now that's going to be split up evenly here. And that's something I don't want. So on this one, and of course everything else everywhere, I need a smart splitter on those. Now, I need a smart splitter because of, so I can, I decide that it needs a primary and a polymer that way. And what he then has left over, he can go down onto that belt. At least when the update comes towards the early access version. Then I can at least balance it out and they can run a lot better. Now also the discovered a very handy use for the signs. These belts 2 times 390, that's 150 per minute. I think he's literally underneath the platform. How the hell did you get there? There's literally one indeed underneath here. Oh, fine, you stay there. So yeah, that was a very useful thing on the signs. To have those here. So this belt is a 1 times 390. Here we have a double belt there. I could also move like one of those belts over here, over this tube probably. But these were working fine here too, so. You see, one of those belts here split up, was full, ouch. Yeah, and then the other one is somewhere further down the line here. Yeah, right here, that one is there, and this one goes over there, and then splits up there. That's how we get the lines. Those lines are leftovers, because every other one I have a refinery left over that's not been used up. All this needs to go around to the other side. So we probably need to build a little bit more foundations here to do that. But I want to set up here a little bit the middle first. Because we have like 20 per minute out. I think this was calculated like 3 or 4 belts or something that I need only. Here in the middle. To get all the plastic that way. So yeah. I think this episode's getting long enough already. I have a lot of work to do still. As you can see. But we have to make the AI limiters. So we can get the smart splitters. Now, I'm gonna do that as a very basic setup currently, because we don't have criterium in it. I need to finish this off first before I can decide where I'm gonna have my smelting of criterium. I want to do that one first, and then after that we can do iron, copper, then we can do limestone and so on, so on. So yeah, I'm gonna do that first in next episode. Get the AI limits, a very basic setup, but I'm just gonna need them here. I really have to get them here. So we're gonna build the other side. I need them there too. So, unfortunately, we won't have the update, but let's see how that's gonna go. Alright, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to press the sub button. And see you all in the next episode. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.